Welcome to the Shikasa Bu Motor Channel. This channel provides easy to understand explanations of car mechanisms. When a vehicle corners, a difference arises between the rotational speeds of the outer and inner tires. It is the differential that absorbs this difference in rotational speed. Differentials have a drawback. When one tire completely loses traction, such as on a snowy road, all of the engine torque is delivered to the slipping wheel. As a result, the vehicle cannot start moving. Moreover, during hard cornering, pressing the accelerator pedal transfers engine torque to the inside tire, which has reduced traction, causing it to spin and preventing strong acceleration. Limited slip differential is what overcomes that drawback. This video explains the structure and operation of a conventional differential, as well as three types of limited slip differentials: mechanical, worm gear, and helical gear. A conventional differential without a limited slip function is also called an open differential. In case of FR vehicles, the engine output is transmitted to the drive pinion via the transmission and the propeller shaft. The rotational speed is reduced by the ring gear, and the axis of rotation is turned 90 degrees. The differential carrier is bolted to the ring gear and rotates together with it. The pinions are inserted into the differential carrier and rotate with it. But the pinions themselves can also rotate independently. The side gears connected to the left and right wheels mesh with the pinions. Let's consider the vehicle's behavior when starting straight ahead. The left and right tires are subject to the same amount of rolling resistance. It can be said that the same amount of braking force is being applied to the left and right side gears. To make the explanation clearer, we will consider the case with only one pinion. Since the same amount of braking force is applied to the left and right side gears, the pinion cannot rotate either to the right or to the left. Therefore, the differential carrier, pinion, and left and right side gears rotate together as a single unit. As a result, the left and right side gears rotate at the same speed, allowing the vehicle to move off. Next, let's look at how it works when turning left. The right tire on the outside of the corner rotates faster than the left tire. This means that the left side gear rotates more slowly than the ring gear, while the right side gear rotates faster than the ring gear. We will consider the case with the ring gear held stationary. The left side gear, which rotates more slowly than the ring gear, can be regarded as rotating in reverse when the ring gear's rotational speed is zero. Since the right side gear rotates faster than the ring gear, it rotates in the forward direction. The pinion is driven by the left side gear rotating in reverse and the right side gear rotating forward. In other words, the difference in rotation between the left and right side gears is absorbed by the rotation of the pinion. This action of the pinion allows the vehicle to corner smoothly. Next, let's consider the vehicle's behavior when starting off with the right tire on ice, having completely lost traction. A large braking force is applied to the left side gear, while no braking force is applied to the right side gear, allowing it to rotate freely without resistance. When the differential carrier rotates, the pinion rotates along the stationary left side gear, and this pinion rotation drives the right side gear. As a result, all of the engine torque is transmitted to the slipping right tire, and the vehicle is unable to start moving. The same phenomenon can also occur when accelerating during hard cornering. When the vehicle rolls heavily, the traction of the inner tire is reduced. As a result, even with increased engine torque, the inner tire slips and strong acceleration cannot be produced. A mechanical limited slip differential is a mechanism that uses multi-plate clutches to restrict differential action. It consists of a drive pinion, a ring gear, a differential carrier, left and right side gears, multi-plate clutches, P pinions, and pressure rings. First, let's take a look at the relationship between differential carrier, pressure rings, and pinions. The inner surface of the differential carrier is grooved, and teeth on the outer circumference of a pressure ring engage with those grooves. The pressure ring can slide in the axial direction of the differential carrier while rotating together with the differential carrier. The pinions are located between the left and right pressure rings, and the pressure rings grip the pinions with spring force. The engine torque transmits to the pinions through the differential carrier and the pressure rings. Next, let's take a look at the relationship between the differential carrier and the side gears. The clutch plate with teeth on its inner circumference is engaged in the grooves of the side gear. This plate can slide in the axial direction of the side gear, and it rotates together with the side gear. A clutch plate with teeth on its outer circumference is engaged in the grooves of the inside of the differential carrier. This plate can slide in the axial direction of the differential carrier, and it rotates together with the differential carrier. When no engine torque is applied, this system absorbs the speed difference between the left and right tires in the same way as open differentials. When the clutch is not engaged, if the right side gear is rotated with the differential carrier held stationary, the left side gear rotates in the opposite direction. Next, we will consider the vehicle behavior during acceleration in a hard cornering situation. When the accelerator pedal is pressed, engine torque is applied in a direction that accelerates the pressure ring. Since rolling resistance from the tires is applied to the pinions through the side gears, a force opposite to that of the pressure ring is exerted on the pinion shafts. Therefore, the pressure rings move ahead of the pinion shafts. At this time, due to the shape of the hole in the pressure ring and the pinion shaft, the pressure ring is forced outward to both sides. The expanded pressure rings press against the clutch plates, engaging the multi-plate clutches. Through this operation, a portion of the engine torque is transmitted from the differential carrier to the side gears via the multi-plate clutch, generating driving force at the tire that is not slipping. There are three types of mechanical limited slip differentials, classified by the difference in operation depending on the shape of the holes in the pressure rings. The two-way type restricts tire slip during both acceleration and deceleration. The one-way type restricts tire slip only during acceleration and does not restrict slip during deceleration. The 1.5-way type restricts tire slip during both acceleration and deceleration, but the restriction during deceleration is weaker. Disc springs are installed outside the left and right multi-plate clutches, lightly pressing the clutch plates at all times. This constantly generates a force that restricts the differential function. This force is called the initial torque. When the initial torque is set higher, the differential limiting force builds up more quickly. However, during parking maneuvers or low-speed cornering, unnecessary differential limiting force is generated, making the vehicle harder to handle in city driving. The characteristics of the differential limiting function can be set by changing factors, such as the spring force of the disc springs, the number of clutch plates, and the shape of the holes in the pressure rings. A worm gear type limited slip differential consists of a drive pinion, a ring gear, a differential carrier, three sets of worm wheels, and side shafts with worm gear. We will focus on the differential limiting mechanism, and for simplicity, consider just one set of worm wheels. A worm wheel with spur gears at both ends meshes with the worm gears of the left and right side shafts. The key point of this system is the relationship between the worm gear and worm wheel. The worm gear of the side gear can drive the worm wheel on the differential carrier. However, the worm gear cannot be driven by the worm wheel. This phenomenon is referred to as worm gear self-locking. Let us consider the operation during a left turn, assuming the differential carrier is held stationary. The right side gear rotates in the forward direction. The right worm wheel is rotated counterclockwise by the side gear. The left side gear rotates in the opposite direction. The left worm wheel is rotated clockwise by the side gear. By counter-rotating, the left and right worm wheels absorb the rotational difference between the left and right side gears. This action enables the system to achieve smooth cornering. Next, let us consider the case where the right tire completely loses traction. A strong braking force is applied to the left side gear, while no braking force is applied to the right side gear. When engine torque is applied, the worm wheel cannot drive the side gear due to the self-locking action of the worm gear. As a result, the differential carrier, worm wheels, and worm gears rotate integrally. This system can reliably transmit driving force to both tires when starting on a snowy road or during acceleration and hard cornering. A helical gear type limited slip differential consists of side gears, long pinions that mesh with the left side gear, short pinions that mesh with both the long pinions and the right side gear, and the differential carrier. Each pinion does not have a central axis, and they are positioned by the differential carrier. The inner surface of the differential carrier pushes the pinions and transmits rotational force. Let us consider the operation during a left turn, assuming the differential carrier is held stationary. Since the right side gear rotates in the forward direction, the short pinion rotates in the reverse direction, the long pinion rotates in the forward direction, and the left side gear rotates in the reverse direction. During actual driving, the differential carrier rotates, causing the right side gear to rotate faster than the carrier, while the left side gear rotates more slowly. There are two methods to generate a differential limiting force. The first one utilizes the frictional force generated on the side gears. During acceleration, the thrust force generated between the side gears and the pinions brings the left and right side gears closer together. The frictional force generated between the friction plates and the both side gears restricts the rotational difference. During deceleration, the left and right side gears are separated and generate the frictional force between the side gears and the differential carrier, restrict the rotational difference. The second one utilizes the frictional force generated between the differential carrier and the pinions. During acceleration and deceleration, due to the shapes of the side gears and pinion gears, the pinions are pressed against the differential carrier and generate the frictional force. The frictional force restricts pinions' rotation and then restricts the rotational difference. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to the channel. We'll see you in the next video.